Hey everyone, a very good morning to all of you. So the day has come when you are going to revise all the questions of your ESI, ARD and GK. The very first thing that you should be aware of about your upcoming NABARD grade A examination is that the ESI, ARD and GK are your merit section and not qualifying sections. Therefore, they assume a greater significance over other subjects of your phase one. And in light of that only, keeping in mind that only, we have organized a mega marathon at 9 a.m. on our channel. So if you want to revise all the questions of ESI, ARD and GK, which can become potential marks for you in the examination, then do come on our channel at 9 a.m. to cover the questions via mega marathon. Okay, so on that note, let's begin today's video as well, where we will be having some questions from the current affairs section from the Spotlight magazine of yours. And before moving on to the first section, let me tell you that you can get the PDF of this session through the Telegram group. The link of that Telegram group is in description below. And in this PDF only, you will get the explanation of the question as well as the answer of the question just after each and every question. So I have put it, the explanation and the answers just after the question for your convenience, so that you don't have to go for the PDF of daily current affairs to search for these questions. Okay. So a lot of complaints were coming to me that they were having problem. The students were having problem in finding the questions in the daily current affairs PDF. So I have tried to resolve that problem of yours. In this PDF PPT, you will get all the explanation of the question in the PPT itself, along with the answers. Okay, so let's begin. Do join the Telegram group if you want this PPT, and subscribe our channel, guys, so that you don't miss out on the important updates. So here is our first question. Which state has launched the millet mission to become India's millet hub? Chhattisgarh, Jharkhand, Madhya Pradesh, Uttar Pradesh, Uttarakhand. So let me give you a hint. The answer to this question is the state which has also launched the Rajiv Gandhi Grameen Bhumihin Mazdoor Nyay Yojana. So this is the same state. Now can you guess which state is it? It is Chhattisgarh. Now under this millet mission, basically fair price will be offered to the farmers for their millet, for their cereal crops. And this is the only objective of this millet mission. Along with this objective, that this state wants to become the millet hub of India. Obviously, if you give the fair price to the farmers and encourage them to grow more millet, then obviously you have the potential to become the millet hub of India in the coming future. So in light of that objective, this mission has been launched by the Chhattisgarh government. Now here, as I told you, the explanation is there, and whatever I explained you is written here. The main point is that in order to implement this mission, the state government has signed an MOU with Indian Institute of Millet Research, which is located in Hyderabad. So this is the star point. This is the important point here, guys. MOU with Indian Institute of Millet Research located in Hyderabad. And there were the MOU with the collectors of different 14 states of districts of Chhattisgarh. Now that is not very important. The important point is this. Okay, so do remember this as well. Where is India's first indigenously designed high ash coal gasification based methanol production plant located? So it is located in Hyderabad. Let me tell you, Bharat Heavy Electronics Limited. So there is a research and development center of BHEL in Hyderabad, and in that center, this high ash coal gasification based methanol production plant has been set up. Because this is the indigenously developed plant, therefore it is important for you to know the company that developed or that established this plant. So the company is this, BHEL. Okay, now what is the use or what is the meaning? So methanol is something that is obtained by using the natural gas, and India does not have abundance of natural gas. It has to import LNG or natural gas in crude form as well from the other countries to fulfill its consumption demands. And in light of that, if India starts to import more and more natural gas just to obtain methanol, then it won't work for India. And therefore, in order to cut imports of natural gas and produce more methanol, this plant has been established, which will use the method of coal gasification, basically turning the coal into gas by using some kind of technique that is not very important. But the important thing is that we are going to produce methanol by using coal, not LNG or natural gas. Okay, natural gas is the substance. So I hope that you have understood this news well. Now it is written here. All the things that I have explained are written here. Okay. Now let me read out this statement for you. Majority of the coal is derived from the natural gas worldwide. Since India does not have natural gas in abundance, therefore it has to rely on imports. And in order to cut imports, this plant will use coal for producing methanol. Okay. I hope that now you have understood the use of establishing this plant. Now guys, do remember, it is established in Hyderabad at the R&D center of Bhel. Bhel is another important point from which the question can be made. Nuakhai is the harvest festival of which state? All the harvest festivals, agricultural festivals are important, okay? So it is the harvest festival of Odisha. It is celebrated just after Ganesh Chaturthi. Okay, so Nuakhai. Nua stands for new and Khai for to eat. Okay, so from here, from this separation of this word, I hope that you can easily remember that it is an agrarian festival, a harvest festival of the state of Odisha. And to be more precise, this festival is celebrated in the western Odisha. Okay, so that is the region which celebrates this Nuakhai festival. With which IIT has Indian Air Force signed an MOU for pursuing academic and research collaboration in the domain of aerospace technology? So this MOU has been signed with IIT Kanpur, and I don't think that there is any need for explanation. This is just an MOU to expand research and academic collaboration in the field of aerospace technology. Okay, so that is the basic purpose of this MOU. Which country hosted the 74th session of WHO Southeast Asia Regional Office? Let me first tell you that however the name is Southeast Asia, but South Asian countries also participated in this 74th session, and the proof is India itself. So Union Minister of State for Ministry of Health and Family Welfare has participated and addressed this session, and the country which hosted this session is in itself located in South Asia, that is Nepal. So Nepal has hosted this 74th session. Okay, so Bharati Praveen Pawar is the name of the minister. The most important announcement that was made during the session is that measles and rubella will have to be eliminated from the region by 2023. However, that is not a new announcement. This is a target that they reiterate again and again. But it is important for you to memorize it. Which edition of the World Conference of Speakers of Parliament has taken place in 2021? So let me first tell you that this World Conference of the Speakers of Parliament, basically this is the 55th edition of this conference, and in 2020 also 5th edition took place, and in 2021 also this 5th edition is taking place. So what is the difference? The difference is that it took place in two parts. In 2020, the virtual format was conducted, and in 2021 the conference was held in person in Vienna, Austria. Okay. From India, the Lok Sabha speaker, that is Om Birla, has attended this conference along with the deputy chairman of Rajya Sabha. So that we will be discussing, don't worry. But first, you need to know that this conference, the same edition, is held in two parts, in 2020 virtual edition, 2021 in person in Vienna, Austria. Okay. Now there are other things as well in relation related to this conference that you need to remember from the exam point of view. Okay. So the very first thing is the names of the organizers: Austrian Parliament, Inter-Parliamentary Union, and the United Nations. The theme again is very important: parliamentary leadership for more effective multilateralism. After this conference, the first global parliamentary summit on counter-terrorism took place. So this was the first edition of this summit on counter-terrorism that took place after this edition only. Deputy Chairman of Rajya Sabha Harivansh and Lok Sabha Speaker Om Birla represented India at the conference, and it took place in two parts, so that we have already discussed. So that was all related to this conference that you need to remember from your exam point of view. Guys, your responsibility is to cover this Inter-Parliamentary Union thoroughly, because this conference is a major event of this union only. So do memorize the factual parts that can become a question in the examination. Who has won the US Open 2021 in women's singles? So it is Emma Raducanu, who is a Britisher. So she is a British tennis player. In the men's single, Daniil Medvedev, who is a Russian, has won. So she's Emma and he's Daniil. Both of them have won the US Open 2021. Who has been appointed as a CM of Gujarat? So Vijay Rupani has resigned and a new CM has been appointed. So the name of the new CM is Bhupendra Patel. He is Bhupendra Patel and the governor is Acharya Devvrat. So guys, that was all for today. I hope that you have enjoyed the video. Do not forget to watch the mega marathon session, guys, because that can be of use for your upcoming examination. Thank you so much for watching the session.